Welcome everyone to the latest episode of the Product Business Podcast. This is Amy Winslow. I am really excited to be here with you, and that was my little dance beat because today is the day that we put the finishing touches on the first draft of our new book. And so yesterday I mentioned that I had gone through a little bit of what if it's not good enough, and all the mind chatter about putting out something new in the world, which I know you'll identify with, because as product entrepreneurs, we love the creative process, and there's the moment where it goes out and it becomes public in the world. So when I was thinking about the content for the book and really putting this together, it kind of came to me that there's about 18 secrets as categories of things to pay attention to and that really move the profits in your business and that really move the money that you make from your product. So we took deep dives into 18 different topics inside the book, and I'm really excited with how it's come out. I just finished the chapter that is on packaging and was reflecting on the elements of packaging that are most important. And since so many of you ask us questions about packaging, I thought I would go over at least the elements here. So one of the things that comes out first with packaging is logo. Should I do a logo? What should my logo be? But before you even think about that, I want you to think about the product naming. Okay, product naming does a lot. You need to decide if you are going to use the company name as the product name, or does the product have a different name? You know, famous example of this from back in the day is RIM, which was Research in Motion, a Canadian company that put out the BlackBerry phone, right, from a while ago. Everybody knew BlackBerry, nobody knew the brand RIM, right? So eventually RIM had to rebrand their entire company to BlackBerry, and their technology wasn't moving as fast as the iPhone and other phones, so they ultimately got swallowed up and they got lost behind the curve of development. But their branding, really, everybody knew BlackBerry. So when you think about this company name versus product name, it's a really important consideration. So some of the other things that you're going to look at with your packaging will be color schemes, because color evokes emotion, it evokes mood and attitude, and it creates a certain affinity with different markets. So you're going to look at the type of packaging, the costs of it, the minimum order quantities that you may have to hit. And one of the really big things is images. Okay, so images can be lifestyle images where you're showing the product in use. They can also be happy people pictures of, you know, that, oh, this type of person uses this product and it works really well and they're really happy. And also you'll probably need some product detail images. The other piece that many, many people do not understand or really do effectively is put marketing text in place. So marketing text isn't just the list of the features of your product. It is as much about the benefits of why do people love that feature, right? For every feature, we like to sit, we write a list of the features, and then we write a list of the benefits of that feature. And then we pick a few of those to really highlight and really focus on to drive the sales. So you should approach it the same way. There is another piece that people frequently miss on their packaging. That's legal notices and things like the UPC area. Legal notices can be warnings, it could be country of origin, your trademark and copyright notifications, your contact information has to be on the package. So there's a lot of different pieces. So this book has an entire list and a chapter specifically about packaging and how it drives sales and how it changes profits inside your business and what that looks like. So I'm really excited to have put this together for you. You'll see it come out very shortly. We're going to go through some proofreading and do a double check. And then we'll be posting it. So I wanted to kind of shine the spotlight on this area of packaging because it is so critical and so misunderstood. And we see a lot of mistakes in this area. And we've seen a lot of results from making changes to packaging. We've actually had one of our clients had an 8-time increase in their profit margin from changing the packaging and a few other behind the scenes things. So that's what we'll be going over in the book. I hope that you like it and that when it comes out, you get a lot of benefit from it. That's completely our intention. So with that, everyone, thank you so much for listening in. We'll have another episode of the podcast up probably tomorrow. So feel free, tune in, learn, dive in deep, and immerse yourself in the vision of what it is you want from your product for you, for your family, and for the people that use it. With that, everyone, this is Amy Wenslow. You can join the live business show podcast recordings sessions on Mondays. Feel free to look in the podcast description and you'll find the website of where you can sign up for the notifications. God bless.